Yo, what is going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. It is time to step up to bat and say swing, bada, bada, swing, because the baseball bat has been officially added to Black Ops Cold War today. There are two different ways you can earn it, either by playing multiplayer or zombies, whatever your flavor. I recommend zombies because you can do it in about 25 minutes. It's super easy to get done with. In multiplayer, you need to use any melee weapon to kill an enemy revealed by your spy plane, UAV, or field mic in 15 different matches. While the alternative is, in zombies, you need to use a melee weapon and kill 100 enemies frozen by your frost blast. Now, like I said, the zombies route is way easier. In fact, if you guys want to get really technical with it, if you go the multiplayer route, you have to complete those matches. You can't get a kill and then back out. You need to actually stay there for the entirety of the multiplayer match, which completing 15 of them, that's already over an hour by time limit standards. So go the zombies route. You can't go wrong with it. I just hopped into D Machina. I went to round 11 or 12. Then I restarted the match and did the same thing over and over again. And it didn't take that long to get the challenge completed. Just like every other melee weapon, I'd like to review the baseball bat in its own video because there are some changes to the standard combat knife that you have with the baseball bat. The first thing that you'll notice is it has a little more range than the standard combat knife. It's not a ridiculous amount of range, but it's definitely noticeable in game. The best way to explain it is it's somewhere between the machete and the shovel. Like, that's where the baseball bat lines up in terms of range. Only a little bit more than the shovel, though. The machete is still going to have far superior range when it comes to actually lunging towards an enemy. But you will have those times where you're using the bat and you end up lunging towards someone and wondering, what the heck, did they bring back commando lunge? Because it does feel that way in certain cases. One thing that completely took me off guard was the swing speed. This is something that we've talked about in the past. Swing speed is super important, especially when it comes down to multiplayer. And I'm happy to say that it's pretty dang quick. In fact, in game, it's compared directly to the shovel in terms of speed, faster than basically every other melee weapon in the category. And that could be because it is a baseball bat and it's meant to be swung, but I was imagining that this would be slower in terms of more like the machete or maybe in lines with the sledgehammer, but it's not. It's actually really fast. The other thing that I noticed with this weapon was I didn't really get caught in any weird situations where the baseball bat got stuck in an animation or like I did this weird lunge and it caused me extra time to pull away. I didn't have any of that happening while playing for a couple of hours in multiplayer. It's a really good time, and I think a lot of people are going to enjoy this particular weapon. There's a nice little callback to the baseball bat that we've had in previous Call of Duty games. When you do a weapon inspect, your character points out to the outfield, basically, and you hear a cheering crowd. This is something that we've seen before with the baseball bat in previous Treyarch games, and it's cool to see that return. In terms of challenges, the camo challenges are exactly the same as the combat knife. So you're going to have to do your standard kills, backstabber medals, you're going to have to do executions and the lot. Once you're done doing that, then you'll get gold, diamond, and eventually Dark Matter Ultra. And taking a look at these from the preview screen, at least, they all pretty much look good. The mastery camos are great on this particular weapon. I don't really like the standard camos and how those look, but the mastery camos, pretty good, especially Dark Aether. So far, you've noticed that I've been playing a little bit on Standoff, which was, of course, a map that we've had back in BO2. It was brought back for the Season 3 Reloaded update. Standoff is always great, and it works particularly well in this game. Just like every other remake that we've had from previous Black Ops games, it works great, and I like the way that it looks in this game. I did, however, want to try using the bat in Die Hardpoint. If you hadn't had the opportunity to play that mode yet, I highly, highly suggest doing so. It's a lot of fun, and it's quite literally a blast, because every time you kill somebody, they explode. And that's no different while using the baseball bat. You can bonk somebody on the head, and they explode in front of you. And what I've noticed with this particular weapon is, if you take damage while you bonk somebody on the head, it actually creates a bigger explosion, which could then kill other people in the vicinity. Now, I've noticed that this happens in general just by playing this mode, but in this specific case, with the baseball bat, it's way more noticeable. Maybe it's because I'm up close and personal, but look at this right here, man. Like, I bonked somebody thinking I was only going to get one kill and ended up getting a triple kill with the baseball bat by only bonking one person, And upon further investigation of the kill cam, or should I say the death cam, those guys were nowhere near this person, and the explosion ended up getting them. That, to me, is just amazing. So running around extra fast, having the ability to do explosive damage with a baseball bat, and of course just bonking people and having them explode in general, that's all a good concoction for lots of fun. So I highly, highly recommend jumping in. Maybe even just doing your regular challenges, or just, I don't know, playing this mode in general with a regular gun. You don't even have to use a melee weapon. It's just a lot more satisfying when you're using a very blunt weapon and you smack them and they just explode. Now, just like multiplayer, the same satisfying thump feeling comes from beating a zombie over the head with a baseball bat. And it's just as fast as the shovel, so this is a good contender for maybe the best melee weapon available in zombies. It's super powerful as is, but once you pack a punch it, it becomes the grand slammer and it can do even more damage. I never ran into any weird issues where I felt like I got hung up on a zombie due to an animation. That happened quite often with previous melee weapons we've talked about here on the channel, but this one is just super smooth as butter. You just go from one to the next, and you never really feel like you're getting stuck on anything, which is a great thing to have, especially when you have multiple targets running at you at once. All right, now I know that there's a big group of people who like to say, well, melee weapon doesn't count as a new weapon because it's the same as every other melee weapon. And although that might be true in certain regards, I just don't agree with you, man. Like, is it okay to have fun with a video game once in a while? I definitely think so. And this is one of those situations where I have fun with Call of Duty. Whether I'm bonking someone on the head, sending them to horny jail, or I'm actually going to blow them up completely while playing Die Hard Point, it's fun to use a baseball bat. Like, it's actually a lot of fun to use, and they didn't mess it up this time. It doesn't take two hits to kill somebody in multiplayer. It doesn't have a really slow animation. You don't get hung up with weird animations. It's just a fast, fluid melee weapon. And it's, once again, another good tool that I'm going to utilize in not only zombies, but also in multiplayer. Final score for the baseball bat, I give it 5 out of 5 fastballs. 10 out of 10, would bonk again. I have nothing else to say. I'm just really happy with it. Challenges are really easy. Of course, you know, unlocking it's really easy. I don't recommend anybody get the bundle because, like, why? Why get the bundle when you could just play the game and unlock it by, you know, spending 20 minutes of your time in zombies? Even if you don't like zombies, you could still get it done really quickly. But that's pretty much it, guys. That's everything I wanted to talk about here in this video today. Let me know what y'all think about the baseball bat down below in the comments section. If you guys enjoyed this video here today, do me a favor, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. Alrighty, folks, I will catch you on the next one. Peace.